Math with Business Applications, Chapter 2, Section 1, Compound Interest. We're going to take a look at the difference between simple and compound interest. And here's a graph that shows the difference between the two. We have a $10,000 investment at 5% over 20 years, and this blue graph is showing us what that value would amount to after the 20 years. It would virtually double. If the interest instead of simple interest was actually compounded, and we'll explain what that actually means, you can see here in the red graph that there is a substantial increase in earnings when an investment is compounded with interest rather than just simple interest. We're going to compound interest to start with by using the simple interest formula. Compound interest is defined as the interest computed not only on the original principal, like simple, but also on any previously credited or earned interest. So let's do a comparison using the simple interest formula. We have a $580 investment at 3% simple interest for 4 years, and the only difference down here is that our interest is compounded annually for 4 years. So the first year there's no difference. Principal times rate times time garners a $17.40 earnings or interest. The second year here on the simple interest, no change, status quo. But on the compound interest side, that interest from the first year was added to the $580, and because we have a higher principal figure in our formula, our interest is higher. Not a lot initially, but it's growing. Third year simple interest, no change, but here we have the interest from the second year is added to the balance from the beginning of the second year for a total of $615.32, and because we have a larger principal, you can see that our interest by the third year has gained over a dollar versus simple interest staying the same. Fourth year, no surprise on the simple interest, but every year, because that additional earnings is added to our principal, we can expect to have a greater amount of interest each year when it's compounded. And here we can see the difference between the two when we've added up the interest earned over the 4 years between the two. We're going to go through identifying the parts of our compound interest formula, and here is the compound interest formula. M is the maturity amount, it's the principal plus the interest. P is your initial investment, the principal. I stands for the interest rate per compounding period, and we'll take a closer look at that in just a minute. And then N, this is an exponential power, is the total number of compounding periods, and we'll also take a look at that. What we need to identify first, though, is what number is associated with a specific compounding period. The compounding period is simply the amount of time indicated for how frequently the investment is calculated. If interest is compounded annually, it means once every year, so there would be one compounding period. If interest is compounded semi-annually, that means twice a year or every 6 months, we would have two compounding periods per year. Quarterly, four times a year, which means every 3 months. If our interest is compounded monthly, that means every month, 12 times in 1 year, and daily, 365 days, or 365 times per year. So let's take a look at a couple examples asking us to determine the interest rate per period and the number of compounding periods over the life of each loan. In this example, we have 6% compounded quarterly. The interest rate per period is what we're going to calculate first, which means we're going to take that 6%, and because it's compounded quarterly, we will divide it by 4. We're chopping that interest up into the number of compounding periods. And this is where the 1.4% is coming from. How many compounding periods will there be? Well, this will continue on for 4 years. We have right now 1 year. We will continue that for the remaining 3 years. Total of 4 years times 4 times per year, or 16 compounding periods. In this next example, they're asking us for the same information, but in this problem, interest is 4%, interest rate is 4%, compounded semi-annually for 5.5 years. The interest rate per period, we will take our interest rate and divide it by the number associated with semi-annually. So if we take 4% and divide it by 2, each compounding period would be earning 2%. How many compounding periods? Because it is semi-annually, there would be 2 per year times the number of years. So we will multiply 5.5 times 2 to give us 11 compounding periods. This last example, we're given a 3% interest rate compounded monthly for 8 years. The interest rate per period, we take our 3% and divide it by the frequency of the compounding. Monthly is associated with 12. So 3% divided by 12 gives us 0.25%. How many compounding periods will there be? This is compounded monthly, 12 times per year for 8 years for a total of 96 compounding periods. We're now going to put those skills together to calculate compounding maturity value. But before we do that, let's do a little refresher on what an exponent is. Exponents are used to represent repeated multiplication. Mathematicians are basically lazy, and instead of, for example, writing out 5/8 multiplied together, we use the exponent to represent that. On your scientific calculator, you have a variety of keys that calculate exponents. It could be the caret, it could be y to the x, or x to the y, where we would put our base, in this case 8, punch this key, whatever power key is on your version of your calculator, and then we put our exponent and most likely hit an equals to give us the final value. So let's put it together with our compound interest formula. And one more time, let's go over the components of this formula. M is the total amount in the account, the principal plus the interest. P is the initial investment or the principal. I is that interest rate per compounding period that we just got done calculating. And N is the total number of compounding periods that we also calculated from those last examples. So here we have Vicki Ewing deposits her savings of $2,800 in an account paying 6% compounded quarterly, and she leaves it in there for 9 years. They're asking us for the compound amount, M, and then for the interest. Before we can calculate M though, we need to determine what I is and also N. Just like those examples we just got done working, I, the interest rate per compounding period, will be found by taking the interest rate, which is 6%, and dividing it by the frequency of the compounding. Quarterly is associated with 4. So our I will be 1.4, and N, the number of compounding periods, is found by the number of years times the compounding number of times per year, which is 36. We now have the components to solve this equation. Our principal, $2,800, times the quantity 1, always in the standard formula for compound interest, plus, notice here we have 0.015, which is the decimal equivalency of the I that we found a minute or so ago, raised to the, this is an exponential power, where we'll need to use our power key on our calculator. This is roughly what it would look like if you put this all in one step in your calculator, 2800, press your multiplication, parenthesis 1 plus 0.015, and paren, whatever the power key for your version of your calculator, the exponent, which in this problem was 36, and press the equals. The result is, or should be, $4,785.59. This is the maturity value after 9 years with this specific information. How much is interest? Well, where did Vicki start out with? She deposited $2,800. Her balance after 9 years has this. The difference between those two will be the interest that she's earned on this account. In the second example, we have $25,000 to invest, and we have some options. Loan out the $10,000 simple interest for 1 year, or invest it at 8% compounded quarterly for a year. Well, simple interest is principal times rate times time. If we're calculating compound interest, we need a little preparation ahead of time, calculating our I, interest rate per period. In the second option, we have 8% compounded quarterly, so we take our rate divided by 4. Our I will be 2%, and N, the number of compounding periods, this is only for 1 year. Quarterly compounding means 4 times per year, 1 times 4, our N will be 4. Calculating that value, we'll take our principal $25,000 investment times 1 plus our I that we found as a decimal, 2% converts into 0.02, raised to the N power, which we found to be 4. Well, in the first option, when you do your multiplication, that interest is $2,500. When you enter this in your calculator using your exponent key, we get the maturity value. We're interested in comparing our interest between these two, so we need to subtract off the principal investment from the mature value or balance after the 1 year. And we see that at a lower interest rate, even though it's compounded quarterly, we're not making as much in this short-term investment. Perhaps if we had a much longer investment, the 8% compounding quarterly would exceed the simple interest. The difference between these two options is $439.20. In this next example, we have $850 to invest at 3% compounded daily for 2 years, and they're asking us for the compound amount in interest. We need to first find what I is, the interest per compounding period, so we'll take 3% divided by 365. Now, this is going to be a small number, and it's best just to leave that calculation for within the formula, and I'll show you what that means. What I mean by that in just a minute. We also need to know what N is, and this is a good thing to calculate what your N value is equal to. Our time is 2 years, compounded daily means 365 times per year. We'll multiply that for 730. Plugging in the values then, and as I said, in place of I actually calculating what that out is, you can put this in the expression, your interest rate 0.03 as a decimal, but then just simply divide it by 365 when you enter that portion of the formula, in other words, I. So calculator wise, you're going to put 850 times beginning parenthesis 1 plus, and let the calculator do what this I actually is equal to. 0.03 divided by 365, N paren, power key 730, hit your equals, and the maturity value after 2 years would be $902.56. This investment started at $850, so we'll subtract that from the maturity value to give us our interest of $52.56.